Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvenni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics in Machines. And this is lecture number 14.3. We are going to solve problems in the hydraulic turbines. In the earlier two lectures also, we solved the problems in the Pelton turbine and the Francis turbine. And in this lecture, we are going to solve few problems in Kaplan turbine from the Anna University question paper. Example number 11 from November 2009 question paper, a Kaplan turbine runner is to be designed to develop 7,360 kilowatts. The net head available is 5.5 meter. Assuming speed ratio of 2.09 and the flow ratio is 0.68 and the overall efficiency is 60%. The diameter of the boss is 1/3 of the diameter of the runner. Find the diameter of the runner, its speed and its specific speed. So, we write down the given data, power equal to 7,360 kilowatts, head equal to 5.5 meter, speed ratio 2.09, flow ratio 0.68, overall efficiency 0.6 and the small d, hub diameter or boss diameter equal to runner diameter, outer diameter divided by 3. Peripheral speed, from the definition of speed ratio, we calculate the peripheral speed u equal to speed ratio into square root of 2 gh. So, 2.09 into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 5.5 equal to 21.71 meters per second. And we calculate the flow velocity, from the definition of flow velocity, flow ratio, vf equal to flow ratio into square root of 2 gh, which is 0.68 into square root of 2 into 9.81 into 5.5 equal to 7.06 meters per second. We calculate the discharge from the definition of overall efficiency, discharge equal to shaft power divided by rho gh. Rho is the density, g is the acceleration due to gravity, h is the head of water available into overall efficiency. So, substitute in numerical value 7360 into 1000 divided by 1000, density is what? 1000, g 9.81, h equal to 5.5 and the overall efficiency is 0.68. So, discharge equal to 200.6 meter cube per second. And the discharge with respect to the dimension of the runner, q equal to pi by 4 capital D square minus small d square. Capital D is the outer diameter of the runner, small d is the inner diameter of the boss diameter into flow velocity. So, pi by 4 d square minus d square is the area for the flow into flow velocity. And we are given small d equal to capital D by 3. So, pi by 4 into d square, capital D square minus capital D square by 9 into Vf. So, the rearranging the terms, q equal to pi by 4 capital D square into 1 minus 1 by 9 into Vf. So, substitute numerical value is 3.14 divided by 4 into D square into 1 minus 1 by 9 into 7.06 equal to 4.926 D square. So, q, the value q equal to 200.6. So, diameter of the runner D equal to square root of 200.6 divided by 4.926 equal to 6.38 meter. And the hub diameter small d equal to capital D by 3. So, 6.38 divided by 3 equal to 2.13 meter. Then the speed of the turbine, n equal to 60 u1 divided by pi into d. So, from the definition of the peripheral speed, so 60 into 21.71 divided by 3.14 into 6.38 equal to 65 rpm. Then the specific speed of the turbine, ns equal to n into square root of p divided by h to the power 5 by 4. So, substituting 65 into square root of 7360 into 10 power 3 divided by 5.5 to the power 5 by 4 equal to 662 rpm. Now, answer to the problem, diameter of the runner 6.38 meter, diameter of the hub or the boss 2.13 meter, speed of the runner 65 rpm, specific speed of the turbine 662 rpm. Example number 12 from November 2010 question paper, a Kaplan turbine working under a head of 20 meter develops 11,772 kilowatt shaft power. The outer diameter of the runner is 3.5 meter, hub diameter is 1.75 meter. The guide blade angle at the extreme edge of the runner is 35 degrees. The hydraulic and the overall efficiency of the turbines are 88% and 84% respectively. If the velocity of the whirl is 0 at outlet, determine runner vane angle at the inlet and outlet at the extreme edge of the runner and the speed of the turbine. So we write down the given data. Head equal to 20 meter, power equal to 11,772 kilowatt, diameter of the runner 3.5 meter, diameter of the hub small d equal to 1.75 meter, alpha guide blade angle is 35 degree, hydraulic efficiency 0.88, overall efficiency 0.84. So, from the definition of overall efficiency, we calculate the discharge Q equal to shaft power divided by rho g h into eta o. Substituting numerical values 11,772 into 1000 divided by 1000 into 9.81 into 20 into 0.84 equal to 71.42 meter cube per second. Then we calculate the flow velocity from the discharge. So, Vf equal to Q divided by area for the flow. So, Q is 71.42 divided by pi by 4, 3.14 divided by 4 into 3.5 square minus 1.75 square equal to 9.9 meters per second. Then referring to the inlet velocity triangle for the Kaplan turbine, we calculate the VW1, wind velocity at the inlet, VF1 by tan alpha, so 9.9 divided by turn 35 equal to 14.14 meters per second. And peripheral speed at the inlet, U1 equal to, from the definition of hydraulic efficiency into GH divided by VW1, so 0.88 into 9.81 into 20 divided by 14.14 equal to 12.2 meters per second. Then referring to the inlet velocity triangle theta, runner wear angle at the inlet theta equal to tan inverse of VF1 divided by VW1 minus U1. So, tan inverse of 9.9 divided by 14.14 minus 12.2 equal to 78.9 degrees. And the exit velocity triangle for axial discharge, so phi value, we calculate the runner wear angle at the outlet, phi equal to tan inverse of VF2 divided by U2, tan inverse of Vf2 equal to Vf1, flow velocity is constant, U2 equal to U1, peripheral speed is also constant. So, tan inverse of Vf1 divided by U1 equal to tan inverse of 9.9 divided by 12.2 equal to 39 degrees. Then, the speed of the turbine, from the definition of peripheral speed, capital N equal to 60 U1 divided by pi into D, 60 into 12.2 divided by 3.14 into 3.5 equal to 66.6 RPM. So, the answer to the problem, runner blade angle at the inlet 78.9 degree, runner blade angle at the outlet 39 degree and speed of the turbine 66.6 RPM. Example number 13 from November 2014 question paper, a Kaplan turbine develops 10 megawatt under a head of 25 meter. The hub and the tip diameter are 1.2 meter and 3 meter, hydraulic and overall efficiency 0.9 and 0.85. If both velocity triangles are right angled triangle, determine the speed, guide blade outlet angle and the blade outlet angle. And the given data, head equal to 25 meter, power equal to 10 megawatt, diameter of the runner, capital D 3 meter, diameter of the hub 1.2 meter, hydraulic efficiency 0.9, overall efficiency 0.85. So, we calculate the discharge from the definition of overall efficiency, Q equal to shaft power divided by rho g h into eta o. So, 10 into 10 power 6 divided by 1000 into 9.81 into 25 into 0.85 equal to 47.97 meter cube per second. And flow velocity, from the discharge we calculate the flow velocity, Vf equal to Q divided by area for the flow, pi by 4 capital D square minus small d square. So, 47.97 divided by 3.14 divided by 4 into 3 square minus 1.2 square equal to 8.08 meters per second. Then, for the velocity triangle, inlet velocity triangle and the outlet velocity triangle, both are right angled triangle. So, the peripheral speed at the inlet from the definition of hydraulic efficiency equal to VW1 U1 divided by GH. So, here inlet velocity triangle U1 equal to VW1. So, U1 square by GH. So, U1 equal to square root of hydraulic efficiency into G into H. So, square root of 0.9 into 9.81 25 equal to 14.85 meters per second. The speed of the turbine, N equal to 60 U1 divided by pi into D. So, 60 into 14.85 divided by 3.14 into 3 equal to 94.58 RPM. Guide vane angle at inlet, alpha equal to tan inverse of Vf1 divided by U1. So tan inverse of 8.08 divided by 14.85 equal to 28.55 degrees. The runner vane angle at the outlet phi equal to tan inverse of Vf2 divided by U2 equal to tan inverse of Vf1 divided by U1. Vf2 equal to Vf1 and U2 equal to U1, which is tan inverse of 8.08 divided by 14.85 equal to 28.55 degrees. Then answer to the problem, guide blade angle at inlet 28.55 degree, runner blade angle at the outlet 28.55 degree, speed of the turbine 94.58 rpm. Example number 14 from November 2019 question paper, determine the efficiency of Kaplan turbine developing 3000 kilowatt under a head of 5 meter. It is provided with a draft tube with its inlet diameter 3 meter and set 1.5 meter above the tail race. A vacuum gauge connected to the draft tube indicates a reading of 5 meter of water. Assume a draft tube efficiency as 78%. So, the given data, power equal to 3000 kilowatts, head equal to 5 meter, HS suction head is 1 point, actually the position of the draft tube. So, look at the diagram, HS is the position of the draft, the tail race from the entrance of the draft tube, HS equal to 1.6 meter, diameter of the draft tube, D equal to 3 meter, P2 by rho g, the pressure head at the entrance of the draft tube, P2 by rho g equal to minus 5 meter, it is vacuum, so minus 5 meter and the draft tube efficiency is 0.78. So, this is 2 is the inlet of the draft tube, 3 is the outlet of the draft tube and HS is the height of the tail race. So, from the inlet of the draft tube. So, applying the Bernoulli's equation between the point 2 and the 3. So, 3 is the outlet and 2 is the inlet. So, P2 by rho g is equal to minus of HS, the height, plus V2 square minus V3 square by 2g. So, V2 is the velocity at the inlet of the draft tube, V3 is the velocity at the outlet of the draft tube. So, P2 by rho g is given as minus 5. So, minus of 1.6 minus V2 square minus V3 square by 2g. So, rearranging the terms, V2 square minus V3 square by 2g equal to 3.4 meter. So, V2 square minus V3 square equal to 2 into 9.81 into 3.4 equal to 66.708. Now, the draft tube efficiency. So, eta d equal to V2 square minus V3 square by 2g divided by V2 square by 2g. So, 2g is getting cancelled. Numerator is V2 square minus V3 square. Denominator is V2 square. So, diffusion efficiency, draft tube efficiency is 0.78, 1 minus, so the other side, right hand side, 1 minus V3 square by V2 square. So, rearranging V3 square equal to 0.22 times of V2 square. Now, you substitute the value from the previous equation. So, here we have the equation, V2 square minus V3 square equal to 2 into 9.81 into 3.4 equal to 66.708. So, substituting here, V2 square minus V3 square, V3 square equal to 66.708. So, V3 square equal to 0.22 times of V2 square. So, V2 square minus 0.22 V2 square equal to 66.708. So, V2 velocity, absolute velocity at the entrance of the draft tube, that is 9.25 meters per second, which is also equal to the flow velocity. Then, the discharge of the turbine, Q equal to area at inlet of the draft tube into velocity. So, the pi by 4 d square is the area into V2, 3.14 divided by 4 into 3 square into 9.25 equal to 65.38 meter cube per second. Then the overall efficiency of the Kaplan turbine, eta O equal to power output divided by rho g q h. So, eta O equal to 3000 into 10 power 3 divided by 1000 into 9.81 into 65.38 into 5 equal to 0.935, which is 93.5%. So, the overall efficiency of the Kaplan turbine is 93.5% is the answer to the problem. Example number 15 from November 2019 question paper, a Kaplan turbine delivering 40 megawatt work works under a head of 40 meter and runs at 150 rpm. The hub diameter is 3 meter and runner tip diameter is 6 meter. Overall efficiency is 90%. Determine blade angle at the hub and the tip. And also at the diameter 4 meter. Also find the speed ratio and the flow ratio based on the tip velocity. Assume hydraulic efficiency is 95%. So we are given the power equal to 40 megawatt, head equal to 40 meter, speed equal to 150 rpm, hub diameter 3 meter, tip diameter 6 meter, overall efficiency 0.9, hydraulic efficiency 0.95, and the middle diameter is 4 meter. So discharge Q equal to shaft power divided by rho g h into eta o. From the definition of overall efficiency, we calculate the discharge. So 40 into 10 power 6 divided by 1000 into 9.81 into 40 into 0.9 equal to 113.26 meter cube per second. And the flow velocity, so Vf equal to Q divided by pi by 4 capital D minus capital D square minus small d square. So 113.26 divided by 3.14 divided by 4 into 6 square minus 3 square equal to 5.34 meters per second. Then we calculate the peripheral speed at the hub. So based on the hub diameter small d, UH equal to pi dN by 60, 3.14 into 3 into 150 divided by 60 equal to 23.55 meters per second. Peripheral speed at the middle diameter, UM equal to pi dm n divided by 60, so 3.14 into 4 into 150 divided by 60 equal to 31.4 meters per second. Peripheral speed at the tip diameter, UT equal to pi dn by 60, which is 3.14 into 6 into 150 divided by 60 equal to 47.1 meters per second. The wheel velocity at the inlet, from the definition of hydraulic efficiency, wheel velocity equal to eta h gh divided by u. So 0.95 into 9.81 into 40 divided by u. So 372.78 divided by u. So now the wheel velocity will change with respect to the peripheral speed at the three different diameter. Now referring to the velocity triangle, so the here we calculate hub VW1 at the hub. So 372.78 divided by the u 23.55 equal to 15.83. VW1 at the middle 11.87 meters per second, and VW1 at the tip diameter, which is 7.91 meters per second. Now look at all the values of VW1, which is lower than the U value. So when the value is lower than the U value, then the velocity triangle is modified like this. So U1 value is higher, VW1 is lower, this is alpha, and this angle is theta. So theta is the angle of the blade at the outlet. So the angle within the triangle is 180 minus theta. Now theta is more than 90 degree. Now we calculate the runner vane angle at the inlet. 180 minus theta equal to tan inverse of Vf1 divided by U1 minus VW1, which is tan inverse of 5.34 divided by 23.55 minus 15.83 equal to 34.67 degrees. And at the middle diameter, 180 minus theta equal to tan inverse of Vf1 by U1 minus VW1, tan inverse of 5.34 divided by 31.4 minus 11.87 equal to 15.3 degrees. At the tip diameter, 180 minus theta equal to tan inverse of Vf1 divided by U1 VW1, which is tan inverse of 5.34 divided by 47.1 minus 7.91 equal to 7.76 degrees. Now from the calculation, we calculate theta. Theta, actually inlet van angle at the hub, 180 minus 34.67 equal to 145.33 degree. Inlet guide van angle, inlet van angle at the middle, 180 minus 15.3 equal to 164.7 degrees. Inlet van angle at the tip diameter, 180 minus 7.76 equal to 172.24 degree. Similarly, the outlet velocity triangle is modified like this. So Vf2 is the flow velocity, U2 is the peripheral speed, and this is the phi, and 180 minus phi. So this angle is 180 minus phi. Now we calculate the angle at the hub, 180 minus phi equal to tan inverse of Vf2 by U2h, which is tan inverse of 5.34 divided by 23.55, which is 12.77 degrees. At middle radius, 180 minus phi equal to tan inverse of Vf2 by U2, which is tan inverse of 5.34 divided by 31.4 equal to 9.65 degrees. At the tip diameter, 180 minus phi equal to tan inverse of Vf2 by U2t, which is tan inverse of 5.34 divided by 47.1, which is 6.47 degrees. Now we calculate the outlet van angle at the hub, 180 minus 12.77 equal to 167.23 degree. Outlet van angle the middle radius, 180 minus 9.65 equal to 170.35 degree. outlet van angle in the tip diameter equal to 180 minus 6.47 equal to 173.53 degrees. Now the speed ratio at the tip radius ut by square root of 2gh 47.1 divided by 2 square root of 2 into 9.81 into 40 equal to 1.43, and the flow ratio at the tip, which is vf divided by square root of 2gh, so 9.9 divided by square root of 2 into 9.81 into 40 equal to 0.35. Now answer to the problem, inlet blade angle in degrees hub at the hub radius 145.3, middle radius 164.7, tip radius 172.24, outlet blade angle in degree, hub radius 167.23, middle radius at 4 meter diameter 170.35, tip radius 173.53, flow ratio at the tip 0.35, speed ratio at the tip 1.43. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering. You may find the fluid mechanics and machinery book here. You can refer to the book for additional problems in the hydraulic turbines, and I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning, and thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So thank you for watching once again. We'll meet again in another video lectures in the fluid mechanics. Thank you.